7-Up bottler. Make 7-Up yours. And in part by Franklin Templeton, gained from our perspective. And by Ford, America's number one choice for 15 straight years.
Saturday at the ACC.
Program.
Top-seeded Maryland is on a mission. Unselfishness and a fearless backcourt motivate this group. Fear the turtle? I think so. The swagger is back with the pack behind its all-conference leader and a pair of three-point marksmen. NC State is dangerous. Duke was caught in a dogfight with their arch rival until their All-American did what All-Americans are supposed to do and put the Tar Heels away. Wake's core of seniors know this is their last chance, but will an underclassman show them the way? The ACC is next. More than 24,000 will jam the Charlotte Coliseum for the semifinals of the 49th ACC tournament. It's all part of Championship Week presented by 7-Up. As North Carolina State faces top-seeded Maryland, the number two team in the country. The winner will take on either Wake Forest or second-seeded Duke. They meet later this afternoon in the second semifinal game. Good afternoon, everybody. Mike Patrick, Dick Vitale. It's great to have you with us from the ACC. Last week, Gary Williams won his first outright ACC regular season championship. Can he win his first tournament championship this weekend?
Well, there's no doubt he could win, Mike. He's going to go for the trifecta, the ACC tournament, the joint, the one he wants, the big prize, the NCAA championship. Certainly has that kind of talent with balance inside and outside.
North Carolina State, certainly no weak sister. It's a great matchup of backcourts. Maryland's advantage should come with that deep and talented front line.
Oh, what a front court. When you think of Maryland's front court, they get the edge against many clubs in America because of the presence of Chris Wilcox and the senior Lonnie Baxter. Then they go to their bench and Randall and certainly Holden, who were productive yesterday, give them great size. And they got an unsung hero at 18 yesterday in Byron Mouton.
Brad Daugherty joins us for the rest of the tournament. And Brad, yesterday, North Carolina State made a living shooting from three-point range.
You're absolutely right, Mike. North Carolina State was very hot from three, shot over 72% from three-point range. They'll need that today. Maryland, a very big physical basketball team. You saw Miller, Grundy, and Eftimoff. All these guys were shooting the three ball well, but look at the depth. Anthony Grundy, 32 big points, but they're shooting the three at such long distances. It's going to force Maryland's big kids to come out and have to defend, maybe give State a chance on the backboard. It's going to be one heck of a matchup.
We're looking forward to it. Let's take a look at the North Carolina State starting lineup. Two freshmen and a sophomore up front, the veteran backcourt of Miller and All-ACC performer Anthony Grundy. For the Terps of Gary Williams, Mouton, Baxter, and Wilcox, and that great backcourt, Blake and Dixon.
You know, it's really amazing, Mike. You just said it so well about a veteran backcourt. In both these backcourts, we're looking at one underclassman, Steve Blake. We got three of the guys, the seniors, are very, very somber right now. Gary Williams, he knows expectations now are so high for Terp fans.
26-3 for the Terps coming into this game, and Herb Sendek, who has had the best season of his career at North Carolina State this year.
He'll feel like $1 million tomorrow when they have the selection show for the first time. It's hard to believe since 91 has NC State been in a big party.
And this is their best record since 1989. Powell, the jump center against Wilcox. Larry Rose, Duke Edsel, and Brian Percy, the officials. Maryland controls the opening tip. Blake, who is averaging over 10 assists a game in his last six.
He really understands what a point guard is supposed to do.
Baxter travel. Lonnie Baxter trying to back inside against Marcus Melvin.
Gary Williams not a happy camper that Mr. Baxter didn't make the All-ACC team.
They are underrepresented in the voting body because the two main papers in the Washington Baltimore area are not represented on the panel for philosophical reasons. So they don't get a lot of base support there.
That's really a great point. I like this kid, Hodge. You talk about a slasher, the freshman. The 24, red, nice cut.
Melvin couldn't handle the pass. Nice pass as well from Powell.
Yeah, you got to make that catch in traffic right like that. You got to get that conversion. Look at Herb Sendek. He worked on the staff with Rick Pitino at Kentucky.
Blake under pressure. Just a wonderful setup guy.
Yes, because he understands what his job is. He really is an orchestra leader. He's the guy who's the maestro man.
And if you need him to score, he can score.
Yeah, he can make open shots as well.
Wilcox missed one from 2 feet out. Archie Miller on the drive. Powell rimmed out.
Wilcox had a tough day shooting the ball yesterday, 1-for-7.
Juan Dixon baseline. Mouton kept it alive. Miller with a loose ball.
Mouton with 11 consecutive double-figure games.
Grundy.
Great move.
Wonderful as a driver, but he missed. Powell offensive rebound.
Patience. You got to have patience in these tournament games. Poise and patience usually leads to points.
Marcus Melvin, a good three-point shooter, ripped one.
He does have great range. He made that dramatic three to beat Houston at the buzzer earlier this year.
He has the best percentage from outside on the team.
They got great chemistry, this NC State team, versus last year.
Last year there wasn't any.
Exactly, zero chemistry.
Wilcox, so strong inside, gets the first two Maryland points.
The biggest mistake Herb Sendek probably made, he made when he didn't recruit Chris Wilcox from Raleigh. Should have locked him up and not allowed him out in the city.
Biggest mistake a lot of people made.
Yeah, well, he's right in your backyard, baby. You don't want him to get away.
Grundy will try a three. They were so hot yesterday.
Shot down with a lot of pressure on him. Maryland's going to certainly play tougher on a perimeter against that three-point shooting.
Mouton wide open, a streaky shooter. He can get really hot.
Take a look right here. Freeze right here is the pick. And there he is, wide open for the three. Uses the screen really well. Great follow through. Watch him wave goodbye. Look at him wave goodbye, the young kid. See that? The little wave. Look at the concentration. Look at the focus. Look at the eyes. And then he says, I'm going to celebrate.
Eftimoff, who's a very good outside shooter and a fundamentally sound player. Miller, he's their most dangerous three-point shooter because he can bury five or six in a row.
They're really good shooting the three when they get it within the offense. When they're rushing like they just was an obvious, not effective.
Wilcox, tough shot on the turnaround, doesn't get the roll. Baxter kept it alive, but here comes Hodge. He loves to run.
He's an athlete in New York City.
Grundy. Good job of keeping his balance. Pretty reverse by Hodge.
He's excellent. Speed, quickness. He's got a great upside at 6'6".
Dixon with a runner and got the roll.
Premier second guard in America, and there are a lot of good ones, but I like his combination of offense and defense. Anticipates well defensively.
Juan Dixon, who has overcome so much in his young life, has a lot of people rooting for him every time he plays.
Great role model, Mike. I was at a banquet with him. I spoke out. He was so representative in a positive way for Maryland.
Grundy would rather drive than take that long shot, and that's why. He's a finisher.
He really can finish in traffic. He has a great step. He knows how to get. Slice the defense, attack the gaps.
7-4 North Carolina State.
Maryland won the two matchups during the regular season.
And as good as Maryland and Duke are, I just don't believe either one of these semifinals is going to be easy.
Got to cut the play. Dox was so effective down in the low post. That's what gives Maryland a great edge. The inside-outside combination that they present.
Melvin, good drive over Wilcox, but Wilcox forced to miss.
Blake head up all the time, looking to find an open man.
Blake will take the three, short. Grundy, the best rebounder on the team.
He's got those long arms.
Melvin got it, he's 2-for-2 from outside.
Well, Grundy goes to the guy that can shoot the three.
Mouton slicing back the other way.
Big time score by Mouton. Transfer from out of Tulane. Played for Perry Clark, who's done a marvelous job with Miami.
3-point shooting so far. 2 out of 4. Mouton nearly with a steal. Hodge, good pass to a wide open Melvin Rindell.
That shot they wanted out of that half court set. They've always under control, has great vision, sees everybody on the floor.
Leads the ACC in assists, second in the country, Wilcox, a little line drive hook.
That's the second time, Mike. That's not a good shot, right? That's a tough shot.
Grundy slashes, draws the foul. If he doesn't make the basket, he is always, it seems, going to draw the foul.
I'm so happy to see him get selected in the All-ACC team. He really deserved it. He's been a catalyst. Take a look right here. See the gap? The seam. He splits really well, protects the basketball, draws the contact. Herb Sendick, you talk about a survivor. Think about what he faced. Incredible what he faced last year. Every talk show word was that he would be a goner. Here he is going to take that team to the NCAA tournament.
Grundy hits the free throw. North Carolina State, the best free throw shooting team in the ACC, a dramatic improvement from years past. And in practice the other day, Herb Sendick was standing right at the free throw line watching everybody shoot free throws, and that's the key to it. You don't practice them, you don't make them.
Yes, work ethic, my friend. You're right. If you have work ethic, a lot of good things can happen. Hey, we're going to take a look right here. Look at the pack. Julius Hodge, a little showtime. There he is with the reverse, sliding and gliding. And now we see Mr. Melvin with the trifecta.
Championship week presented by 7-Up, Marquette, Cincinnati. Conference USA Championship. Cincinnati hadn't won one since 98. Hogan had a huge game. There the dish to McElroy, who lays it up and lays it in. Bearcats 30-3. Seed Hogan hits for 26, Mike.
All right, thanks, Carl. It's 12-8. NC State with the early lead here, and freshman have certainly played a key role in North Carolina State's resurgence, their first 20-win season in 13 years. And Josh Powell primarily contributed in the paint this year. While the Jewels of New York led all ACC freshmen with over 10 a game, and Ilian Eftimov, an uncanny ability to make the right play, the Pack improved 7 games from last season, poised to return to the big dance.
Well, the Diaper Dandies have really been positive contributors, and there's been great balance with the freshmen and the veterans like Miller and Grundy. There's been great balance and great respect for one another and super chemistry. Last year, I didn't think they had any chemistry at all.
12:47 to go, first half. That zone, and Blake with a perfect pass, and Holden can't hold it. That's a bullet.
He really drilled that diagonal pass right through the defense. Got right in the gap of that, saw the opening, and right to Holden. Holden and Randall played well yesterday off the bench.
They did.
And Florida State now with that gap to 42-41, and then Maryland went on a 23-zip spurt.
Kerry Williams actually walked out of the timeout huddle.
Yeah.
He said, I'd already told him everything I could possibly tell him. I just wanted to get away and sit down.
You better not say that too often. He said, why are we paying you?
As Marcus Melvin has hit 3 of 4 from outside. He has 9 big points.
And that's the one weapon that neutralizes the great interior play of Maryland.
Clifford Crawford is on as part of the press.
He's got a lot of experience, veteran player. Started a number of times in his career.
Herb Zendek's got a pretty good bench.
Yes, he does. Not afraid to use it either.
I think Randall's going to be called for a foul away from the ball. That'll be 1.
There's Eftimov. Look at that great screen, man. He lays that screen. And Melvin utilizes the screen exceptionally well. There are a lot of players that don't know how to use the screen. Best I ever saw was Steve Alford when he was playing for the Hoosiers. And Bobby Knight let him get a national title in 87.
Last foul was on Taj Holden and not Ryan Randall. Scooter Sherrill, number 23, in the running club.
Scooter's had some great moments coming off the bench for North Carolina State. Met his dad. His dad was a football player at South Carolina State.
Melvin goes baseline and banks it in. 11 points for Marcus Melvin.
Melvin says, hey, I'm multi-dimensional. Gary's upset. He wanted a 30-second timeout. He is furious. Look at him. Look at the intensity.
Really upset with his team's defense.
And he will let them know about it, my friends.
They have given up 17 early points. They're down 17-8.
There's Melvin in triple threat position. You can shoot, you can drive or pass. He says, I'm going to drive. Floating in the air with the left hand. There he is. Look at him floating in the air. Super South. He's got a really great upside to his game, as does Hodge.
Melvin has 11. The Terps have 8. And that helps his inside game when he can hit those threes. You saw the way Taj Holden rushed at him and left his feet, which set up the drive.
I tell you, this guy's a masterful motivator. You don't win like he has won 26 games. I said to him before the game, this is the best team you've ever had. He said, wait a minute, Steve Francis, the gang, won 28.
Drew Nicholas in the game as Maryland goes to a smaller lineup.
Red zone. They're going to try to find the gaps of that zone.
Eftimov touched it, but so did Randall. And the fourth Maryland turnover early.
You know what they've done really well here at North Carolina State? They have done an exceptional job in defensive transition as we look at the turnover ratio, 4-1. Herb Sendich kids are coming back defensively. We have not seen a transition layup for Maryland.
They lead the ACC in points allowed. Crawford knocked away by Mouton. Eftimov is back. Mouton forced it and got the foul.
Mouton attacking, taking the ball to the basket, creates the opportunity. And I was just thinking, Carl Ravitch had mentioned in the studio about a number one seed that Cincinnati's chasing down. Think about this. Maryland looks like they'll be a lock for a number one in the East. That means Washington, D.C., where they're playing. Syracuse, Duke, I think, to be a number one in the South, because that means Greenville and Lexington. But not only that, Mike, it means if it were to go to the Final Four, East plays, for example, plays the Midwest, the South plays the West. So if you're in the East, that means you'd get Kansas in a semifinal if they were to get there. I think you'd rather avoid Kansas.
So the people around here would say, hey, that would set up a Maryland-Duke national championship.
Could be.
They may meet the third time tomorrow in the championship game, but North Carolina State and Wake Forest are going to have something to say about that. Mouton nearly had another steal.
I tell you, continues like this, we may have a consolation game tomorrow, Duke and Maryland, if they play in terms of the level that they played early in that game against Carolina.
Thank goodness they don't do consolation games in that thing anymore. Those are just brutal.
I agree with you.
Pretty good against the pressure defense.
Spread the court, get good spacing. Spacing so important. Both clubs so well drilled.
When Blake's going to be all over Miller, you want him to drive, not have that outside shot.
That's so great to see Miller healthy for once. He's had so many injuries in his career.
And it's a travel on Scooter Sherrill.
Larry Rose with the call, got a good crew on the game.
Marcus Melvin with 11 points, 11 of the 17. Wolfpack up early.
Welcome back, everyone. LSU trying to ruin some teams that think they have a shot to get in, taking on a tough Mississippi State team. Ontario lays it up and lays it in, and it's 31-28 Mississippi State over LSU. McNeese State is in. Last 5 years, the winner of the Southland's been a 5 seed.
...17-10, North Carolina State on top of Maryland. Let's check in with Brad Daugherty. Brad?
Thanks, Mike. Marcus Melvin only had 8 points in yesterday's game. Today, he's come out and he's done a great job shooting the three balls, setting himself up, going to the basket. He has 11 of North Carolina State's 17 points. Let's watch here early. Nice pass back from Hodge, wide open. You don't expect the big kid to shoot a three that well. Almost the identical spot. Two possessions in a row, he gets 3 pointers. That sets up this. A nice drive to the basket. Marcus Melvin, they're going to have to contend with him before the day is over. Back to you, Mike.
Brad, he's one of the most versatile players to come around in a long time. You'll see him handling the ball an awful lot. He's very good against the press. He beat a double team yesterday dribbling the ball behind his back between two players. I don't know if Herb Sendek is real thrilled with that, but it worked.
You know, he talked about, Brad, about how effective he is inside-outside, and that combination makes you lethal. But you know what's really helpful in NC State? They're really passing the ball exceptionally well. They have an assist on every score.
11-26 and counting, first half. There's a reaching on Grundy, the first foul on the senior from Louisville.
Right now, Mike, I look at the tempo of the game, and the tempo of this game really is dictated by Herb Sendek's kids, and they really, I think, love this tempo.
Unless they start turning the ball over and people get a chance to run on them, it stays this way.
Two great screens up high by Maryland.
Nicholas couldn't get loose. This is Mouton, tries to get down the lane, pull up. Good screen by Eftimov inside.
Understands how to play. All right to the goal. Nobody there.
They left the middle wide open. Baxter got there late, committed the foul as well.
Poor job by Maryland in defensive transition. Gary Williams not happy there. Nobody got back and communicated. You got to get back and you got to find the ball. You got to find the ball. Nobody finds the ball. Look at this here. Look at that gap. Look at that seam. I can even get through that gap, man. I know my guy Doherty can. Look at, I can get through that gap.
Nice job by Eftimov because he set up the rebound at the other end, screening off the lane, and then hustled down court, got the return pass. It's 20-10.
Look at that run. Look at that spurt by NC State. They're making it a 5-on-5 game. Maryland not able to get in transition.
Wilcox backing in against the double team. Doesn't get the roll. Baxter tried to keep it alive. Got it back.
He got fouled.
The NC State fans wanted a foul on Baxter getting the rebound. ESPN's exclusive coverage of the ConAgra Foods Big East Championship culminates with a game tonight at 8 Eastern on ESPN. UConn against Pittsburgh. College basketball's championship week presented by 7-Up.
Two teams that have had great years, Jim Calhoun and Ben Holland. Certainly right now, that game could possibly mean a number two seed. You know what, though? I get a big kick, Mike. You ready for this? I'm talking about number two seeds, number five seeds. Over the last 5 years, a number 10 seed has gotten to the Sweet 16 as much as a number two seed. 900.
It's amazing.
That's amazing. So what does that all mean? Go wacky about 2, 3, 4. I have to get by the heavyweights. There's so much balance.
20-12. A little pressure by Maryland. Trying to trap.
Trying to speed up the tempo of the game. Wants them to shoot the ball a lot quicker.
Hodge had a three and pass on him. Melvin trying to go.
Oh, nice play.
Great pass to Hodge. What a pass by Melvin.
Great pass, but better than the pass was the motion without the ball. So many kids can't move without the ball. Hodge does that well.
Mouton. Tough fadeaway and it won't go. There seems to be a lid on for the Terps right now. And then a foul.
Julius Hodge showing that lost arm. We're going to see him right here. Now we're going to watch him right with the backdoor cut. There he goes. Right back court. Nobody communicating. Nobody talking on defense. You must see. You must see ball. You man.
Maryland hasn't had a field goal in 4 minutes and 49 seconds.
Brad, Maryland having a tough time getting their big people involved in a low box against that NC State defense.
They really are, Dick. You made a great point earlier about North Carolina State. They're doing an excellent job of spacing the floor, creating avenues and alleys to pass that basketball just like that.
There it is. Great call, Brad. Great backdoor cut by Melvin. Oh, they are playing well. They are playing exceptionally well. This ain't forget about Duke and Maryland. What about us getting to the final?
24-12. We've passed the halfway point of the first 20 minutes. Gary Williams trying to exhort his team to step it up and get back into this. How about Melvin so far? 13 points, 2 assists.
Take a look right now. Backdoor cut. Maryland not doing a good job of seeing ball. Man, look at Eftimov with that great bounce pass. Melvin really the star of stars. He's feeling good. He's feeling excited. But he's got to understand there's a lot of basketball to be played.
9 field goals on 9 assists for North Carolina State so far. That's a wonderful job.
I mean, I'm a dummy and I can figure it out. It's 100%. That's perfect, baby.
Yeah, but how long did it take you to figure it out?
See, now, I wouldn't do what they did there. I would try to go trap it and open up the court against Maryland.
Juan Dixon got the kind of firepower that can bring him back. Baxter fighting for the rebound. Kept it alive. Great job by Lonnie Baxter. Blake got the roll.
I would change my defensive game plan. I know you like to have different looks, not to get teams in rhythm, but if you start trying to trap Maryland, you open up the court for it.
Grundy had it tipped away from behind by Dixon.
And they do that so well. Dixon, outstanding defensive player.
ACC steals leader all the time. There's the three from... Oh, it was Drew Nicholas.
Nicholas off the bench has been so effective. See, this is Maryland basketball. This is Gary Williams basketball. Forced to turn over, run the ball up the court.
You have to be careful with North Carolina State. They can have wide open threes, and they can hit them. Hodge for three. And a foul on the Wolfpack.
Don't you feel a little momentum starting to go the other way now, Mike?
Absolutely.
They really are. Now watch Nicholas. You're going to see him run right to the three-point line. See him right here? He's going out to the three-point line. There he is. And he can spot up and shoot it. This is a danger time right now for NC State.
Drew Nicholas has become so valuable to this team because he can come in and play the shooting guard, knock down threes. He can come in and handle the ball and do that very well. Nicholas again. Holden kept it alive. Todd Holden with a follow.
That's great when you can come off the bench with a guy like Holden or Randall with those big bodies. They're back. This is the Terps now you've seen in the last 2 minutes.
Maryland's had 7 points in the last 102. Miller can't save it.
They need a timeout. They need a timeout and regroup because right now Uncle Mo is on the side of the Terps.
Maryland was being dominated to the last minute and 15 seconds. They have roared back to cut the lead to 5.
And that's why you're 26-3. You know you have a sense of pride. You're going to regroup. And this guy will let them know about it, Mr. Williams, as well. Believe me, they're not going to sit back and not hustle and scrap where they won't play.
It is so difficult at times to get kids fired up when they go in with the same idea that we do, that Maryland and Duke are probably going to end up in the final. So you play your first round game, your second round game, and you're sort of saying, well, we'll save everything for the final.
Well, you know, the bottom line is when you lace them up, you better come to play. But there's so much of the psychology of the game, the mentality that goes in. Right now, Maryland, all of a sudden, after being down by a dozen decided to step it up, and they start playing with a little more intensity.
Terps have hit 3 of their last 4 after starting cold, only 4 of 15.
What's given them that little run has been their defense. Their defensive effort's gotten a lot better.
Dixon.
Big time when he gets in that 3-second area. There's the floating jump shot. He can shoot the medium-range jumper, the long-range jumper.
Juan Dixon came into this game needing only 49 points to surpass Lenny Bias as the all-time leading Maryland scorer. He just got 2 more.
They're back with their defense. Herb Sendick knows it. They're a different team right now defensively with their pressure defense.
The run has reached 11-0.
23-0 yesterday. They're like Maryland and Kansas. They can put so many points on the board. They're going back into a zone right now. Got to find a gap and shoot the 3.
Eftimov can do just that. Too strong. Blake with a rebound. Good decision by Blake. Nicholas for 3.
They're going to show a little more patience right now. Good rebound from the guard, Scooter Sherrill. NC State's got to regroup. They need a basket big time. They were up 24-12.
Here's the guy who's led them in scoring. Now they get it to Grundy. Good job to drive the baseline. Kicks it out. Sherrill wide open. Ouch.
Wow. Wow. That's Big City USA on that one.
Miller dives in. Has the loose ball to Grundy. He's great in the open court.
Did a great job pulling up, shooting the medium-range jump shot rather than go right to the basket and possibly charge.
He makes brilliant decisions in the open court.
You know, and he did early in his career. Shows you the maturity of staying around.
First point they've had in 3:20. Dixon way short on a 3.
He's angry with himself right there on that one.
Thought he was hit on the elbow.
Take a look at the All-American. Look at Juan Dixon moving without the ball. Gets right into three-second area. And there's the little fadeaway Jay. And then we're going to see him defensively where he's outstanding. Defense starts it. They're going to kick the ball out. And here comes Mr. Dixon going right to the goal, baby. Yes, sir. An All-American, a PTP, or a primetime performer.
North Carolina State has had its lead cut to three. When Juan Dixon first came to Maryland, wasn't much to look at, wasn't a great player. Boy, oh boy, how things have changed.
He weighed about 145 pounds coming out of high school, and he's gotten a lot stronger. He's a much bigger person now, even though he still looks thin out there on the court. And, you know, nobody wants to win more than Juan. I mean, he's a scorer, so he knows where the basket is. But the big thing for Juan is us winning games.
Fifth-year senior. I'll tell you, experience. You look there, they have, what makes that team special is all their experience. When you look at Mr. Dixon, and you think certainly of Baxter with his experience as well. Mouton, very experienced basketball team. In fact, I was talking to our own Brad Daugherty just yesterday about the fact he stayed in school 4 years, and the experience that he had certainly made him a better player as he progressed in his career at North Carolina.
And this has been the best 4 years, certainly because of Juan Dixon and Lonnie Baxter and the other talented Terrapins that this school has ever had. Baxter through two players, foul. Really? Herb Sendek doesn't like it.
I tell you, he was down in here. Three people around him. Herb says, you got to wave that off. Don't get it. This is not the NBA. Got the foul before he takes it to the goal.
Archie Miller will get the foul for a reach in.
Did a great job in a post right there. Baxter was superb last year in the West Regionals, was the MVP, leading Maryland to the Final Four.
Baxter makes the three-point play. Guess what? We're tied.
Here comes that pressure. They retreat, and then all of a sudden, when you get in a certain spots of the floor, they rotate into a double team and then rotate over. The rotations are usually excellent, coming to the basketball, leaving the weak side open. Then they're falling back into a zone. Reverse, you got to get Miller some shots against that zone. Got to get Miller some shots against the zone.
Scooter Sherrill out of the corner.
Understanding who your shooters are so important.
Foul was on Drew Nicholas. We're at the ACC semifinal. North Carolina State has led the entire way in this one. Our first tie is at 26-26. NC State with the ball. Sherrill in the corner. How can you not find Archie Miller against the zone?
He had 16 points.
There he is. And lost it.
They did a great job attacking him. Had 16 all in the second half yesterday with four threes.
Blake getting some up-tempo movement. Tries the three. Got the roll.
And that's what he can do. Gives him a little threat from the perimeter as well as a guy that can pass the basketball.
Maryland first steal. Blake with a steal.
It's Maryland. That's why they are right now one of the top three teams in the nation.
Somebody threw the switch.
Gary Williams.
That's right.
Gary Williams in that timeout.
Five turnovers in 4 minutes for North Carolina State. It's been the key to the turnaround.
Steve Blake, what a job. Oak Hill Academy, there he is shooting the three, gets the bounce to come his way, and then we see him rotate. There he is right now, squaring his body. There's the good wave goodbye, the backspin, the rotation.
31-26, Maryland on a run. Crawford checks in for Herb Sendek.
You know, it's really amazing. The zone defensively has really bothered NC State.
It has.
Because the wrong people have shot the basketball.
19-2 run. Grundy has to dump it off to Efremov. Miller.
About the time. Net barely moved. About time. Got to get him some shots. He's the right guy. Even though he shot down from downtown Durham, North Carolina, man. That was downtown.
His 64th three of the year. With 21 to go in the half. Kitchen on the run. Can't hit it. Here comes Grundy back the other way. barely kept his pivot foot, and that inside shot.
Nothing like the trifecta to give you some momentum to get you back in the game. Two in a row.
Grundy is just so cool. He pulled up. First, he didn't want to walk. Then everybody ran by him, and he said, why not, and buried it.
And you know, it's amazing. He's got a funny-looking shot by
him. Doesn't he ever? But it works for him.
He's got those long, long arms, though. Makes him a lot bigger than what he is.
Eftimov called for a hold underneath.
Look at Grundy creating some space there for Miller. And Miller with that long-range jumper, man. He didn't shoot that from Charlotte. And then Grundy says, watch this. I'm going to be under control. I look right. I look left. I said, why pass it? I'm just going to shoot the J, baby. Nothing but nylon, Mr. Grundy.
Looking at Kansas dismantling of Texas Tech early on, and they're doing it from the inside, they're doing it from the outside. Drew Gooden's been on fire. Bosch's hit a three. It's 22-9. We'll look at this game and much more at the half, including the Big Ten showdown between Indiana and Iowa. As close as it can get, Mike.
All right, thanks, Carl. This is pretty close too. NC State by a point over Maryland. Never in the 49-yard year history of ACC basketball has a team placed more than two on the first-team all-conference team. Well, congratulations to Duke. You did it. All-purpose point guard Jason Williams. Versatile forward Mike Dunleavy. Plays like the coach's son that he is. And the great post work of Carlos Boozer led the conference in field goal percentage. Duke, again, making history in the ACC. Well, Juan Dixon also made it, but that guy did not. Lonnie Baxter, and it has a lot of people upset at Maryland because in his career, third in rebounds, he's got a chance to be only the second 1,000-point rebounder in the history of this school.
And as Blake would have scored, you know, you mentioned Baxter, and I can understand them being upset. They win the league by two games. They dominate the league, basically, winning it by two games. And the bottom line is, you think when a team would win the championship, maybe get three, but in a second slot. But when you look at Duke, it's pretty tough to leave Boozer off that team.
It's impossible.
And then Grundy had such a great year. But I've said so many times, Mike, just give me Maryland and Duke. I got five. You got the rest of the nation. I'll give it to my guy Ravage and Phelps. I'll give them any five they want to take those five, but we got a great shot to win.
Maryland stays in that zone. It's been effective. Miller had that one blocked. Randall came down on top of him.
Randall did a great job attacking the three-point shooter.
Dixon loves that cut across the lane. Scoop came out.
Maryland certainly a different team after that timeout when they were down 12.
Grundy. Offensive foul on Grundy.
Who gets it with the call. A little bit out of control. As Mr. Sender on a great staff with Billy Donovan, Tubby Smith, Rick Pitino, Ralph Willard. There he is going to the goal. There's the defense set right up, no doubt about it. Ralph Willard was on that staff as well, taking the Holy Cross for the NCAA tournament.
Nine turnovers so far for North Carolina State. They trail Maryland by one with 2:58 to go first half in the ACC semifinal.
Maybe average 13. Heading to top that.
Blake had it knocked away. Miller ahead for Grundy. Dixon is back. And Grundy had it bounce off of Juan Dixon out to North Carolina State.
Brian Kersey says, no, we're staying here. His dad, Jess Kersey, working in the NBA out in Sacramento, one of the real solid officials. Gary, you talk about a guy with a passion. Perspires, pours his heart and soul, former Turk point guard. Talked to Gene Shue today. He was at the Legends Brunch that I spoke at when he honored all the greats like Phil Ford, Ralph Sampson. And I'll tell you, Gene Shue certainly speaks very highly of Mr. Williams and what he's done with his alma mater.
Poor pass by Grundy, and Mouton will try to take it in, and he's fouled by Marcus Melvin.
You know, good foul right there. Had the layup, didn't try to hurt anybody, but it's not going to at least make him go to the layup. To the line, there's a poor pass. Grundy makes a bad, bad play. And here's the contact, gonna make him go to the line. He really attacks Mr. Mouton.
Mouton, the senior from Louisiana, hits the free throw. He's in the top 10 in the ACC in that category.
Had a nice game yesterday with 18 points. You know, it's really interesting. Carl talked about the Indiana game with Iowa. Iowa Steve Orford underachieving all year. Thought they would beat Wisconsin. Said it when I was down in that studio. It was a big win for them. But right now, the only chance they got in the NCAA tournament, they got to win the Big Ten like they did last year.
Mouton, by the way, has been perfect from the line in this tournament. He's 12-12.
There goes that pressure.
Grundy, the dish and the foul as Hodge cuts inside.
Hodge comes from a great program in New York City.
And a technical. All right, who gets the foul? The technical is going to be on Taj Holden. And the personal.
Had a technical yesterday. A technical was called on Mouton yesterday, Mike. Those are things you don't want. You don't want your players losing their cool. That could end up being big when you get into a close game. He's not going to stop on that sideline. This guy's automatic.
So that's three on Taj Holden, because the technical also counts as another personal.
Yes.
And Gary Williams is just really letting this officiating crew have it.
He's lucky he's got a veteran crew that's very patient. You're going to see him right here. There's the contact. And there he is. Going to tee him up. And Larry Rose ain't gonna, he's not going to waste any time. You're not going to show me up on his baseline, says Mr. Rose.
Coming up on the 7-Up Halftime Report, Carl Ravitch, Digger Phelps. Take a look at some of the bids that have come in today. Conference USA Finals. And we'll preview Duke and Wake Forest. And Hodge the free throw line with the Mitch.
Super year for Cincinnati, winning that final over Marquette. Just a great, great year. I just hope they don't forget. I know, Mike, I just feel, because I was at a little school in Detroit trying to make it up the ladder. When I think of teams 25-5 like the Butlers who last year beat Wake Forest in the tournament, and Southern Illinois, the Salukis, 26-7. I don't want to hear about RPIs and who they play, because nobody gives them a chance to play them.
Well, you've already done your job. You've got your 116 field set.
No, 120.
Diggers, 120, I see.
Hey, Carl better control Digger. I count it, he's at 125.
Excellent first half. We are tied at 35. Pressure by NC State.
One thing I like about NC State, they took a real punch from Maryland, but they didn't totally fold when Maryland made that run to get back in the game. They're still scrapping.
Mouton looks for Wilcox. Blake trying to get away from Crawford. Mouton cut off in the lane. North Carolina State does a great job helping inside. And it's a shot clock violation.
Good job defensively. You know what I was trying to mean there, Mike? A lot of times when a heavyweight team like a Kansas or Duke or Maryland gets you on a ropes and gets momentum, they usually knock you out.
Exactly.
But this club has come back and scrapping and clawed. They scrapped the club right here. Look at this. And they're going to force right there. There's going to be the shot clock violation. There it is. It's going down. It's going down. Look at Hodge says, we're going the other way. Play for Gary DeCesar, St. Raymond's High School, New York City, the Bronx, one of the great high school programs.
Eftimoff is back in for Herb Sendek. And Grundy got it.
He can post inside. He's got those long arms. He's sweet as can be. Anthony Grundy, all ACC.
Grundy has 11. He has moved into the top 10 all-time in North Carolina State scoring history. And Eftimoff will be called for a foul.
Ooh, look at Herb praying. Look at Herb praying. Don't have to pray for a bit, Herb. You're getting a bit, Herb. Herb, what a difference a year makes. Oh, what a difference a year makes, Herb.
I don't think he's considering the bid right now.
No, I don't think so either. Look at Grundy. Look at Grundy getting great space inside. Uses himself well. Really a good extension to the goal from out of Louisville.
Free throw is good by Wilcox. Grundy is 6'3", but he's got the arms of somebody who's about 6'9".
Hey, Brad, we're looking at Wilcox on the line. There's a lot of rumors that he may entertain going to the NBA. I think, personally, he needs at least another year to polish his game. Your evaluation.
I totally agree with you, Dick. He's gotten better since the beginning of the season, but fundamentally, he still has a ways to go. Unbelievable athlete, but another year will just help polish and hone those skills, and it builds another year of character, which is also important when you take that next
step.
Well,
he said yesterday the press conference is coming back, but you know that. A lot of guys say yeah, and then they're thinking of it.
They're coming back. You look the size of those checks. Makes it hard to come back.
I tell you, Mr. Grundy, what about that downtown? Should I pick the mic?
Grundy makes it a 4-point lead. Blake against the trap. Grundy is a big-time player.
What a year he's had. You can just see the confidence he's playing with.
Blake, nice crossover to get into the lane. Wide open shot. He has a soft touch on that shot.
Yeah, you know, he looks like he's gliding, that he's not super quick, but he has the ability to go from north to south.
11 points, 4 assists. A great start for Blake.
Averaging 10 assists, you said, a game. He's having a phenomenal season. They're in a zone right now. They want to try to get you to a trapping area. I'm going to take the clock down and sit back, spread the court.
3-second difference between the game clock and shot clock.
Spread the court. He can shoot it.
Hefted him off. Too strong. Blake for the rebound.
You don't want to foul down here. You don't want to foul. I'm going to make a silly mistake.
Blake trying to get it off. He did.
Good half, partner. Good half. Really a good half.
Melvin and Grundy combined for 27 of the Wolfpack's 40 points in the first half. As the Wolfpack shot 54% from the floor, they lead the number two team in the nation by 2 at the half. Let's go to Carl Ravitch. Served in the first half for North Carolina State, Hodge and Melvin and their senior leader Anthony Grundy lead the Wolfpack to a 40-38 halftime lead. They shot 54% from the floor, 6 out of 15 from three-point range, and they nearly matched Maryland in the fast break department, trailing by only 2 points. Outstanding first half. Glad you could join us from the ACC. North Carolina State did not come in here just to make an appearance, did they?
Oh, not at all. They want to advance and win. They want to deny Gary Williams his first ACC championship. I'll tell you, Grundy and Melvin played superbly. Between them, they were 10 for 14, scored 27 air points, and went dynamite. But they're going to have to do that again in the second half.
Maryland tried to crank up the defensive pressure, created some turnovers, got back in the ball game. And it's been neck and neck ever since. Blake, 11 points, 4 assists in the first half. Duke Edsel enjoying a little laugh with Gary Williams. Only you notice Gary's not laughing.
Gary, does he laugh at all?
No.
You know, after the game, he'll laugh a little bit. Especially if he has a W. If he has a W, he's not laughing with an L, I can tell you that.
He birdies 3 straight holes in the offseason. He'll laugh.
He loves golf. Plays a lot with Dave Gavitt. Architect of the Big East, not doing a great job with the Hall of Fame.
Melvin short on the three under pressure.
They got to get Dixon some shots. He's got to get out and transition a little bit, Maryland, as well.
He was held to 6 points in the first half. Baxter can't handle the pass. Here comes Hodge. Hodge, end to end.
He really can get to the basket. He's got superb quickness. He was a blue chip primetime performer out of high school. Herb Sendick was able to convince to wear their uniform over Syracuse coming out of New York City.
Wilcox helping on the press. Wolfpack by 4. The winner goes on to the championship game tomorrow. We'll play the winner of Duke and Wake Forest. Dixon, double team. Nearly lost it. Wilcox.
Nice little turnaround, jump hook down to that baseline. Getting position is the key for Wilcox. Getting himself in good shooting position.
Wilcox nearly got the steal on the press there.
So athletic, a great elevation. Tempo. Notice how they want to control tempo in a game. They don't want to play in a racehorse style up and down the court.
That's where they got hurt in the first half when things speeded up.
Yeah, when they went to that little pressure, defense opened up the court.
Shot clock at 7. Grundy finally gets it with 4, now has to force the 3. Not a good possession.
Not a good possession at all. Didn't get the kind of shot they wanted it. Framework of their offensive sets. Oh, Baxter was wide open. They missed him down in the box. Get him the ball.
Mouton was wide open in the corner for a 3. Another turnover. Here comes Hodge. Blake trying to catch it.
He's got a little showtime in his game. He's got a little. He's got a little New York City in his game. He's got that hip hop and skip. Look at a tug coming out.
44-40.
Another fair player in the ACC used to have his tongue hang out.
Oh, yeah. As he was 3 feet above the rim. Juan Dixon saying again he was hit by Grundy. You don't see Juan Dixon miss a jump shot that far unless he was hit on the elbow.
They're going to right now the defensive play, doubling up on a post inside. Here's Hodge with the steal, stepping in the passing lane. Here he goes, puts it in the left hand, takes it to the goal. Looks down. Now look at the tuck. Look at the tuck. Hey, is that a mini Michael? Oh, that's a mini Michael.
Last foul was on Hodge. It's his third. And Mouton misses the free throw.
Maryland really has improved on a free throw line. Right now, third in the conference, shooting 70.5. Earlier this year, they struggled. Had a big game on the line, but it came back from nine down, which I thought was the game that broke the spirit of Virginia. I thought that hurt Peter Gillen's club big time in that game.
Thought it hurt them, and it made Maryland's year. Grundy ahead of the pack. Dixon got back. Fouled.
What a great play by Grundy. The way he attacked the goal. He never veered to the right. He stayed on a straight line. He didn't give the defensive player an angle. Now watch this. On a straight line to the basket. There he goes, right to the goal. What a year he's had. Look at those long, long arms, all ACC, 1991. So hard to imagine that a school with the tradition of NC State has not been in the NCAA tournament since 91.
Three-point play for Grundy, who leads his team in scoring, rebounding, and assists. Can't do much more for your ball club, 47-41. Maryland turns it over again.
Maryland looks a little bit lethargic to me. I don't know, Mike, do you feel that way?
I do.
They look a little bit lethargic, almost like we could turn the key on and we'll get this thing going. They've ignited and it doesn't happen many a time.
Three turnovers so far in this half for the Terps.
Spread the court, use the screen up high. I believe they got to get Miller some looks. They've been doing a great job playing it.
Eftimov, tough pass. NC State can't control it. Eftimov is an excellent passer. That may have been asking too much.
He's got a great feel, understands the game. Dad's still playing over there in Europe. Brother played at North Carolina.
Dad must be something.
Said he sends him tapes. Has his dad and his brother look at his tapes all the time.
They don't have a 38 and over league, do they?
I don't know who's paying for those tapes being sent. Yeah, they got a 30. Who's paying for those tapes? That ain't an NCAA violation, is it? No, I'm only kidding.
Now they're going to try to move some of the photographers back. Good luck. This is it's very difficult to buy a ticket here. It's very difficult to get a press credential here.
Exactly. I tell you, what a great job John Swofford and Freddie Barraquette do with this tournament. The granddaddy of all the tournament. They organize it so well. Everything's done first class.
Blake against the double team to Wilcox. Missed the runner. Got it back. Wilcox with a follow.
I think they make a mistake when they start doubling up. I really do. I think Maryland is too talented to double up. They're going to find the open man, and then you're going to have lanes to the offensive boards.
I think that's the key, Dick. It gives them a chance to get offensive rebounds. They already have a big advantage inside.
Yeah, it's tough to block out.
Blake. Wilcox. Baxter tried to keep it alive. Here comes Grundy.
Should back it out right now. Get the high percentage shot.
Miller. Cut off by Blake.
Good job defensively by Maryland.
And come off for three. Rebounded Grundy. Averages 5.5 a game. And Baxter called for a foul. And Lonnie Baxter was almost asking for that foul. He kept bumping Grundy. Finally lifted a knee and hit him. That's two on Baxter.
Yeah, they were a little slow blowing a whistle right there. Could have had it a lot earlier. Take a look right here. Watch right now. Now watch the knees. See, finally the knee goes in there. I mean, not trying to hurt him, not deliberate, but the ref says, I caught you, Lonnie. You're too big to get away with that.
Well, you just wonder what Baxter was thinking.
Yeah, so far away from the basket.
47-43, Wolfpack by four.
Trying to run that high post, cut off the shuffle cut. Little down screen. Grundy likes to down screen and post on a box.
Miller. Dude, that was from Greensboro.
Baxter shaping up with a mismatch inside.
Leans into Eftimov, no call, basket Baxter.
Great recognition, good IQ basketball-wise, taking advantage of the M&M-er, the total mismatch down to the low block.
The lead is two. Oh, Baxter again, out on Eftimov. Eftimov scoops, got it!
Great.
He's
play.
A smart player.
Yes, he is. Great play going down the lane, but I'm really disappointed. Normally, you see Maryland come over and close that angle, that driving angle.
Juan Dixon with a miss, and Powell with a push-off inside. Or Marcus Melvin checking. That's two on Melvin.
Oh, here come the Dukies, baby. Boozer, Dunleavy. Oh, he's a fair player. Here comes Mr. Williams carrying his ball. He's carrying a rock right by the ESPN truck. Let's go say hello to our producer.
Back to the ACC in a second. First, we check the SEC. LSU, Mississippi State. This is a good game. Hutchins gets the ball, puts up a shot. Some good defense there, but Jason Wilson gets hit. 51-50 right now in favor of LSU with 3:20 to play. Second half of this one just underway. Indiana leading Iowa 35-34. We'll keep you posted on both. Ohio State, Illinois still to come in the Big Ten.
All right, Carl, it's 49-45 here. NC State with a four-point lead. Let's check in with Brad Daugherty.
Thanks, Mike. North Carolina State's done an excellent job in the transition, getting the basketball out in the open court, taking advantage of that speed. You see right here, Julius Hodge out in the open court. That's what he does best, slashing to the basket, just like Dick said earlier. Nice job once again, stepping in, picking up the air pass. Boom, finish on the dunk. Tongue flying. Look at this pass by Eftimov. Perfect, right in stride with Anthony Grundy. There's the foul on Juan Dixon. They need to continue to push that ball in transition, create gaps in space, get shots.
All right, Brad, 15:06 to go. NC State by four. Maryland basketball, Blake to inbound. Baxter has been a non-factor so far. You got to credit the NC State interior defense for that. Wilcox has been, though. Wilcox has nine.
Right over the top of Marcus Melvin down inside. That's where he's so effective. He's got that great bounce off the floor. Can't teach that.
6'10", and he can jump. It's a pretty good combination.
Yeah, he's got to really work a lot, though, on post moves inside. Listen to Gary and his staff. Coach Dickerson, Patsos, Kavarik, and those guys working with him down on a low block, teaching him all the moves.
Hodge to Crawford, now to Grundy Lowe. He loves it down here. Triple team this time, though. Dixon set it up, and then they trapped him.
They did a great job surrounding him like a triangle.
What a catch by Dixon. What a pass by Blake.
Wow, he started the defensive error down and out into the floor, and then he sneaks out in transition. And that's where he excels, but that's been minimal here today.
It's like catching a Dan Marino 15-yard bullet.
Ooh, he was pretty good throwing the football, huh?
Pretty good.
I got a feeling you're a Dan Marino fan.
Oh, man, he's the best.
Oh, he's a paisan.
He and Johnny Unitas, they were the best.
Guy named Montana wasn't too bad either.
No, he wasn't.
And your partner wasn't too bad, Mr. Theismann.
Absolutely.
And there's Mr. Blake. Nice pass. Look at that catch. Made like a wide receiver. Great hands. Maybe somebody will draft him as a wide receiver.
Blake is so great off of the dribble. Doesn't have to pick the ball up. Six assists in this ballgame with 14:09 to go.
Great passers normally can't do that. Do it really well. You go to the next level, which we'll have on ESPN next year at ABC. You watch guys like Jason Kidd. Oh, look at the backdoor cut.
Great backdoor cut. What a great pass by Eftimov. Eftimov is a tremendous passer.
I'll tell you, that pass was right on the money. The great bounce pass. Good-looking kid. He's got the whole package. Looks passing the ball.
Blake left alone and buries it.
He can basket. He can also shoot.
Maryland back by one. You just had the feeling this was going to be a great one.
Now NC State's going to take the hit. Now can they come back?
Miller, Blake really hustled to get out on the 3 points.
You almost get the feeling you're going to see Maryland's best hit right now.
NC State survived it in the first half.
Oh, nice bump off the screen up on top. They use Eftimov really well as a passer.
Miller, shot clock at four. Melvin, open for three. That would have been huge.
Miller did a great job creating the opportunity for Melvin.
Wilcox backing in on Eftimov. Short, and Eftimov with great position for the board.
Hodge has to work on his range as a shooter. Everything right now offensively for Hodge is to the basket. With his slashing, his speed, his quickness.
Shot clock in the left corner of the screen. See how much of it they use on this possession. Wolfpack down by one, 12:34 and counting. Hodge, nice pass to Eftimov. Nice reverse and the foul.
They are playing so well as a team. That is what we call a team, my friends. T for togetherness, E for effort, A for attitude, and M for mental toughness. You take a look at the little triangle on the inside. Watch him how to get the ball into the paint area. And there's Hodge, they got a little triangle. Two guys at the boxes, the guy in the middle. Nice look by Hodge, very versatile, Eftimov. I'm telling you, he's a man for a freshman, I'll tell you that.
Did you spell team or tam?
Team.
T-A-M. Oh, thank you.
T for togetherness, E for effort, A for attitude.
I missed the effort part. I thought you said tam.
Oh, I'm a dummy, but not that dumb. You got me nervous there.
Made you think, though, didn't I?
Yeah, made me think.
NC State by a bucket.
They back in the zone now. Hodge up on top of that zone. He's got the long wingspan. He can bother perimeter shooters.
Hodge holds in to play the high post.
Good ball movement. This is what NC State wants to make it. A 5-on-5 game. Beat us in a half-court set.
Shot clock down to 9. Blake will try another 3. Kicked out of bounds to the Wolfpack.
NC State would take their chance in that sequence of a 5-on-5 set like that.
We're at the ACC semifinals at a sold-out Charlotte Coliseum. First of 2 games today. Eftimov driving in, down, and he didn't get it in.
Great job by Maryland defensively. Eftimov with an error. Herb getting closer and closer to CMI Barber. I pay $7.50 a pop, stealing money.
Randall, Nicholas with a follow. Good job by Nicholas. Maryland loves to crash the boards, get everybody involved.
Well, you said a little bit earlier, Mike, he's such a valuable guy because he can play a multiple number of positions. He's versatile.
Foul was on Clifford Crawford, his second. Only the 3rd team foul against the Wolfpack in the second half. Gary, Maryland's committed 4.
Every possession, coaching. He's coached in all the big leagues. He's been in the Big East, the Big Ten. Did a solid job at Boston College, who I believe is going to get in. I think the Big East is going to get 6 teams in. You watch BC and St. John's show up on that board. He also did a good job at Ohio State with the Buckeyes.
Yes, he did. 2 more teams as part of Dick's 120-team NCAA field. We are tied at 54, 11:56 to go for the right to go to the ACC Championship.
Championship week continues here on ESPN. A look at the Big Ten game, Iowa and Indiana. Watch Pierre Pierce. And obviously you see it's a 4-point ball game. This has been back and forth the entire time, 38-37. Hoosiers at the free throw line trying to add to their lead. Mississippi State, by the way, now less than a minute to play in this game. They lead it 53-51. We'll get you a final shortly, Mike.
All right, Carl, we're tied here. NC State and Maryland, the NC State freshmen have played a pivotal role in their success and ultimately could be one of the best freshman classes in the country.
And they don't say much. They listen to the coaching staff. They work extremely hard. And if a player, you know, has to say something to one of them, they're reasonable and they listen. And, you know, I think that's the key for a lot of teams, you know, is accepting criticism sometimes from players and coaching staff. And we've been able to do that. Everybody has enjoyed one another, and they've done an unbelievable job on the court as well. They've produced, you know, a lot of minutes for us. And I don't think there's a better class in the country right now that's doing what, you know, what they've done for us.
Got to be happy for them and happy for Archie Miller as well. There's Eftimov on the bench. Archie Miller injured the last 2 years, not able to practice on a consistent basis because of that leg injury. It's fluid buildup. Full court pressure.
I like what he said about accepting criticism. So many guys can't accept criticism.
Grundy, baseline, just so tough inside. Takes it right at Taj Holt, the 6'10 player, who's a good defender, and he can't stop him. 19 for Grundy.
He does a great job of protecting the basketball, Mike. He really does. And he has that uncanny way of releasing the shot in traffic.
Blake calls out what he wants. Juan Dixon hasn't had many touches lately. Now he's got a 3, but under pressure. And Archie Miller, the smallest guy on the court, has the rebound.
Not a good shot. You wonder now if the size starts taking over for Maryland down the stretch. I think the one way you negate that is you start making a few 3s.
Jordan Collins, number 32, is in.
Is it size?
Melvin, who was so hot early. That ball's knocked out of bounds with 13 on the shot clock.
Hasn't had many looks. Look at Grundy right here. I mean, he knows he can score. He protects the ball so well. Utilizes his body as he's sliding and gliding and hanging. And those long, long arms that make him so much bigger than what he is. And that's why he's so efficient.
Crawford, they've got to get it up. Shot clock's at 8. Crawford doesn't realize it. Down to 5. Now he does. Drives, and they bail him out with a foul. Juan Dixon commits the foul with 4 on the shot clock.
You know, every time you think that North Carolina State's going to get put away, they just keep coming back, scrapping, clawing, fighting. You know, we keep talking about heavyweights. We watch North Carolina. We talk about, for example, yesterday, North Carolina with that delay game. Good strategy, obviously, to get that delay game against Duke, and everybody got really pummeled. But the bottom line I'm trying to point is that Duke, no matter how good they are, Kansas, how good they are, and Maryland, hey, they've been really challenged. You take a look at what Kansas and Nebraska took them right to the wire. You take a look at Wake Forest against Maryland, and Maryland had a great chance to win that game.
Absolutely.
They didn't have the technical in that game. And Duke certainly has been, you saw with Virginia on the road.
Lonnie Baxter in this game has only had 3 field goal attempts. 3.
They're doing a great job of keeping the ball out of his hands, matching up really well, fighting him down to the box inside. See, right now, this game is more half-court oriented than Maryland would like it to be.
Baxter with his 4th shot, and it's a miss. Good defense by Jordan Collins.
Patience right now by NC State. Really big with each possession.
Archie Miller. Got it!
He can flat out shoot the 3. He's as good as any 3-point shooter in America if he gets open. It's like almost automatic. He's battled all kinds of injuries.
Now the lead is 6. And the party Maryland had planned for tomorrow may not come off if they don't get with it.
And it may spoil the big TV party of a possible Maryland and Duke matchup. Wake Forest may have something to say about that as well.
10:09 to go. NC State now up by 6.
Mississippi State's last loss was to LSU. That was in the middle of February. They haven't lost since, and they've now won 7 in a row. They get to the SEC final game, 57-51. They'll play the winner of Alabama, South Carolina. Few teams breathe a sigh of relief now that LSU is out.
We're here at the ACC tournament. North Carolina State shooting 56%. And pretty good from 3s, too, Dick.
Watch Miller right now how to utilize. See the freezer right here. And he gets himself wide open. It becomes a 2-man game against Blake. And he gets open, and Blake tries to react. A little bit slow getting there. You give Miller any kind of daylight. Look at this right now, how he squares his body. Exceptionally well, his brother now, former Pitt player, coaching at Xavier as an assistant. But Thad Mata, what a great year they've had.
It was pretty easy to get open on that one.
That's the key. They got to get some open shots for their guys that can shoot threes. And what a job they've done containing Maryland and keeping them out of transition.
Blake calls out the set he wants. The Turks have gone without a field goal for 3.5 minutes.
His owner is going to collapse inside on Baxter.
Wilcox down the lane. Good move and got it. Chris Wilcox doing his part. He has 11.
Well, he stepped right in the gap of that zone, found that seam, and then went right down the lane for the easy shot.
Trying to create the turnover. Miller grabbed the ball, wisely called a timeout. He'd have been trapped right at midcourt.
Good timeout. I'll tell you one thing. Maryland is very effective after timeouts when they've been behind. And that's a credit to Gary and his staff. First half, they were down 12, had the timeout. He got in some bases, and they were absolutely a different club.
Of course, Dixon and Baxter, two of the best players in Maryland basketball history. Those are the guys you count on, the guys you expect to come through for you. Certainly Lonnie Baxter has not had a game he'd like to write home about.
Well, no, either is Dixon. Dixon has not had a knockout All-American kind of game. And I credit that to the plan that they've had defensively. They've done a great job surrounding those guys. But more than that, they have eliminated the transition game.
Baxter averaging 15 points a game. He only has 9. And really, Dixon has shot the ball poorly today. He's only 4 out of 12. And well under his average. A lot of time to go, though. 9:39.
Yeah, he's capable of going on a spurt and breaking it open quickly. This Maryland team so explosive, like Duke. They can score in bunches. I like the way NC State has really spread the court. Spacing so important. We talk about how important it is in an offensive setup. He's a great baseline player.
Grundy gets the roll. He is brilliant inside of 20 feet.
He is excellent on the baseline. He's a baseline beauty, baby. He has that great knack of getting free.
Blake's got to beat the 10-second count. Just did. Now Dixon is double-teamed and knocked out of bounds. Last touch by NC State.
I'll tell you, the big guy, Marcus Melvin, out there on the top of that pressure. Very effective in a trap.
Hodge is going to come back in. Crawford will go out for Herb Sendak.
Trying to get the ball out of Blake's hands because they know when it's in his hands, some good things happen.
Baxter, Aftermath reached in and fouled him trying to get the steal. ESPN's exclusive coverage of the ConAgra Foods Big East Championship starts, or culminates rather, with a championship game at 8 Eastern on ESPN. It's UConn against Pitt. That's tonight. Hope you'll join us for that one. Nicholas knocked out of bounds by Hodge.
And that combination of Brandon Knight and certainly Page, just brilliant. What a tandem they are. And Connecticut, I love Mr. Butler and their new kids, Okafor and Ben Gordon.
Baxter on the inbounds. Lonnie Baxter got free that time and scored.
Well, had some space inside. Trying to take them into a trapping area, but they're spreading the court. And then Hodge can see right over the defense. See with that great size, he can see right over the trap.
Got some excellent passers in the game right now for North Carolina State. In fact, all of them.
And that's so important when you talk about dealing against that pressure of Maryland. Look at the way they spread the court.
Hodge baseline, triple team and stuck.
Had no shot there. Had no shot there. That's well shot. So hello. Hello. That's a monster job, baby. And that's when the Terps are at their best. Coming off the block shot, the steal, transition. Hello.
He doesn't shoot layup, does he?
Oh, he's up and away, baby. He's the elevator man. Great head fake.
Aftermath, nice fake, dig it open, and he answers with a three.
You know what he said? He said, your dunk was impressive, but you know what? My little one-hander is worth three. I'll take three against two. Look at Melvin playing on top.
Hodge with a steal.
Give it up.
Two on one.
Great
and
play.
Hodge is fouled in the bucket.
Oh, Mr. Patrick, what a great play. Give and go, baby, going off the run. These kids don't want to be denied. The Wolfpack fans don't want to be denied. They don't want to be denied. They're all standing. Take a look at the steal by Hodge. Give it up. Get it back. Take it to the rim. Score.
Two mistakes on the same play by Blake, who thought he got all ball. First he commits the turnover, then the foul at the other end, and a chance for a three-point play for the Wolfpack. They're already up 67-60.
I know why now. My partner gets all excited about the ACC. I tell you, they ought to salute you. They ought to, after all the years, 20 years, the way you sell this conference, I am talking to those people. I should salute my guy, Mike Patrick.
Tell you what, Dick, just the opportunity to do it has been plenty for me. 67-60, 7:59 to go in this game.
Coverage of the Indiana-Iowa game. Jared Jeffries would be on the other end of this break here, and Indiana starting to put a little distance between themselves and Iowa. Jeffries on a little gimpy ankle, and able to turn the reverse, and they are up by 47-42. Meantime, Kansas all over Texas Tech, 65-27. They beat them soundly in the regular season and are doing so again, Mike.
Wow. Carl, 65-47. Wow. Ouch.
Ouch. He's coming on our selection show tomorrow night. Bobby, not able to show up after that.
North Carolina State is hitting 65% of his shots in the second half. Juan Dixon is not hitting 65%.
No, he's not, because the credit to defense. Look at the pressure he's facing on every shot. Hand right up in the face. Now they chase him out of range. Look at this here. They chase him way out. Challenge again. So he's not really getting great opportunities. NC State, 19 assists on 25 field goals. Hey, Brad, are you surprised like I am that Maryland's not been able to get this game to be a quicker pace and get up in transition?
I'm really impressed, Dick, with North Carolina State and the way they've been able to slow down the pace, as you guys said earlier. The one thing that surprises me about Maryland, it's a different possession each time for them. When they go down one possession, they'll throw it inside. Next time down, the ball's either thrown away or a quick shot's taken. There's no rhythm to this ball club right now.
Wilcox with a path to the basket and draws the foul.
Let me ask you this, Brad. You've been part of some great teams when you played at North Carolina. You come in, you think of NCAA championships. Obviously, that's the standard for Maryland right now and Duke. Do you think there's a tendency to hit a wall a little bit in terms of when you get to the end of the year like this?
Absolutely, Dick. You go through the long basketball season, and you're always watching the schedule, and especially within the ACC Conference, because, you know, the last part of the year, you're right in the middle of all the tough conference play. So you're looking towards the end of that year, having a great year in the conference, regular season, and before you know it, here you go, you got the ACC tournament, and sometimes subconsciously it's just hard to get yourself prepped to come out and play. You know you're going to take someone's best shot, and they'll catch you off guard sometimes.
Eftimov has to leave with his fourth personal foul at the 7:51 mark. Wilcox at the line now has 14 points.
I'll tell you, what an addition a guy talking to Eftimov has been. Larry Hunter, in over 500 games in his career, a great decision. I thought he got a raw deal at Ohio University. He did a super job. Won 19 games there, and he gets fired.
Hodge nearly stolen on the inbound. Miller hustles across the timeline. 7:42 to go in the ballgame.
Shot selection so big now as you come down the stretch. Understanding what a good shot is and the right people shooting the ball. Using that shot clock, as you can see. 35-second clock was changed to 35 in 1993, was 45 seconds prior.
Miller. Not really the guy you wanted to have it with five on the shot clock. Jordan Collins, Juan Dixon.
That's where he excels. See, there it is again. They excel in transition. Run, baby, run. That's the Turks game. Run, baby, run.
They're back within three.
You know they're not going away, Mike. You know that. They're not going away. You're not 26-3. You know what?
Herb Sendek is outraged right now. He thought Lonnie Baxter drew a foul as he banged into Collins.
Maybe you don't want a technical now. A technical will be crucial.
Grundy, this is a guy you want.
Oh, oh, what an unbelievable play. Are you serious? Are you kidding me, Anthony Grundy? Are you for real?
23 points for Grundy, had 32 yesterday.
He has come to play. He's the early leader for that MVP award.
He's hit 9 out of 12 shots. He's special. Wilcox spins away from the double team. Missed the shot. Kept it alive, but Miller got the ball.
They tried to take the angle of his drive, tried to spin in a lane away from him.
Very few second chance points for Maryland, which is a strength for them. 69-64.
Oh, Miller! Get a T.O., baby! Gary's gonna need a T.O.
72-64, it's back to 8.
That was a pull, but it's a backcourt violation.
Biggest lead has been 12. NC State comes out running.
They're gonna use the shot clock. They're gonna manage time. They're gonna spread the court. And they all, as you said earlier so well, Mike, they all can pass the ball. Look at the way they're reversing the ball, looking for open men. Now there's a double up, somebody's open.
And it's Miller, wrong guy to be open.
He's got to get a timeout. He's got to get a timeout. Get a T.O., Gary. Get a T.O. to Wolfbacker for real. This could be Upset City. Upset City. Will this affect the number one seed? Does Duke still have a chance to be number one in the East? We don't know.
NC State lived with the three yesterday. They hit a school record 13 in the ACC tournament. So far today, they've hit 10.
The theme has been unselfishness. Let me find the open man. Freeze it. Right here. He's going down here, baby. He's seeing a double up. He's finding the open man. There it is. The hook pass. And you don't let this guy open. You don't let this guy open. And then Mr. Melvin says, I'm going to show. Look at the screen right here. Look at it right here. He's wide open, baby. He's wide open. Wide open. My guy Doherty would like to shoot that open shot, Big Brad. Yes, sirree. What about Grundy? What about Grundy? He does it the hard way. Driving and slashing.
Melvin is 4 out of 7 from long range. Miller is 3 out of 6. The lead has grown to 11. You think Anthony Grundy's on the all-tournament team?
You think he belongs on the all-tournament team? You think he belongs all-ACC? He has been the guy. 8-0 run, man. What a court.
Terps are going to need Juan Dixon to get real hot.
Gary's so effective with timeouts. He does a great job remotivating his club. You got to get that ball up on the glass.
Baxter with a miss. Grundy tipped it to Miller.
And the foul on Mouton.
Maryland just can't hit inside shots.
Oh, a lot of pressure on him on the inside. They really surrounded him. NC State really fighting and scrapping. Not settling here. They just get to the semis. Look at him scrapping to the ball. I tell you, they got a nice young nucleus coming back. 1-on-1 right now, says Marty Arnoff, our outstanding stat man.
And now Miller will go to the line 1-1. Archie Miller's an 86% free throw shooter.
Why let him shoot it? It's automatic. It's automatic. Why waste time? He can speed the game up, put it in the book, and let's play.
Well, he will miss 14 out of 100.
Yeah, that's true. You got to hope that these aren't the 14 if you're North Carolina State. They're the leading free throw shooting team in the ACC.
Five players in double figures. The lead has grown to 13.
Can you believe this? Can you believe this?
Maryland has lost only three times all year. One of those in the conference. Juan Dixon with a miss.
He's trying to carry the club now, creating opportunities.
Hodge commits a foul. That's four on Julius Hodge. Eftimoff already on the bench with three. But it's a 17 foul, so they go to the 1-1.
What a great story last year, Maryland, when they were 15-9 and lost to Florida State at home. And they turned it around, went on an unbelievable run to the semifinals where they lost to Duke. Just an incredible turnaround. Something very similar to what we've seen with Illinois. Illinois was 15-8 this year, struggling big time, 4-5 in the conference. They can use Gary's team as an example.
Maryland can ill afford any more mistakes in the last 4:40. Down 12, Mouton could cut it to 11.
What a brilliant game, though, that's been played thus far by NC State. Utilizing passing, screening, defense, all the phases of the game that usually lead to the winner's circle.
They beat Virginia in the quarterfinals yesterday by 20.
And played really well.
Yes, they did.
They beat them and played well, and Virginia was in a state of urgency. And they didn't guard anybody. Virginia's defense was just unbelievably poor.
Dixon dives on the double team, can't come up with it. Melvin will bring it up.
He has got a heck of a future, Melvin. Long arms, range as a shooter.
There isn't anything he can't do.
You usually don't see that kind of combination for a big player. He's got great touch from deep. There he is with the rock in his hands. Handle it.
Collins is getting a lot of minutes right here. Shot clock at 7, and Melvin launches a long one.
Big story here has been that Maryland's defense has not been able to create offense for them. They haven't been able to utilize that defense and create opportunity. Now, 14 to 21 in the second half doesn't hurt, and that's what NC State has shot, Mike.
Now, the question here is, did the ball hit the rim? It did, so they'll get a new 35 on the shot clock, and they'll use as much of that as they can.
Set on it. Doesn't hit that rim. It's a violation.
Hodge guarded by Nicholas.
He's played a solid game, Hodge. He knows he's limited shooting, so he hasn't tried to shoot from the perimeter. He's more of a driver, slasher, poster.
Miller short. Hustles for the rebound. Blake has it. Miller fouled him, I believe.
No doubt about that. Now you put him on the line, it's like automatic getting a deuce.
Blake and Miller chasing that loose ball, the third on Blake.
I watched him shoot free throws in a pre-practice session. The guy didn't miss one. It was unbelievable.
Had the Dick Vitale stroke going.
Oh, mine's usually Brick City when I got the shirt in time. I'm a little tight. This kid is automatic. Our partner could shoot, man, Mr. Darby.
Miller is 5 out of 5 from the line. He has 14 points on the afternoon. It's tough to come back against a team that shoots free throws that well, and NC State does. They're up by 13.
Still has about 11 minutes left to go in the second half. Eastern Washington is up 52-48. Following the conclusion of our game, Digger and I will be here to update you on all that has happened. And boy, Digger really misses you, Dick. I can tell you that.
miss him. I miss you, Carl. We got to talk some baseball, Carl.
3:56 to go in the game. North Carolina State has outscored Maryland 25-12 after it was tied. And right now the Terps are in danger of losing only their fourth game this year. They finished the regular season, their best record ever at 15-1 in the conference, the first outright title since 1980. And they had come into this game winning their last 13 games, but they're in a whole lot of trouble right now, partner.
A whole lot of trouble. I'll tell you this, Mike. I'm not trying to make excuses for them because they don't need excuses. They've had a great year. But I just have a gut feeling, it's my gut feeling, that Maryland and Duke, the standard for excellence for them this year is not about just winning the ACC tournament. It's the NCAA championship. And anything less than that would be considered a disappointment in their fans. And no matter how much the coaches like Gary and Mike sell their kids about coming to play, I almost think they want to get on with the NCAA tournament. I don't know. That's just a feeling I have.
But don't let that diminish the effort that North Carolina has put up today.
No, not at all. They played brilliantly. Not only today, yesterday. Great effort defensively, offensively.
Dixon with Grundy right in his face. He buries the three.
And remember, there's a lot of time yet on that clock.
Miller, good catch.
It's important that the right guys get fouls. You want to get the ball in the hands of Miller.
Excellent ball movement by North Carolina State. Offensive foul called on Grundy.
Again, there's the timeout by Gary Williams. They take advantage of it. They get Dixon going. I mean, he's moving without the ball. He's going to pop up off a screen, turn, good rotation, and drills it, and then they force the turnover. This is a big possession for Maryland. They need some momentum. They need a score here.
79-69. Taj Holden can shoot the three. Brick that one off the glass.
Shot it too quickly. Too impatient. Plenty of time on that clock.
Miller trying to get past Blake. What a pass by Miller. And a great decision by Collins to bring it out.
Yeah, because he didn't have the good angle for the layup.
And a foul on Dixon.
Well, they want the ball in Miller's hands. It's Miller time down the stretch. He's like automatic.
Collins understood it was far more important to have that clock work.
Smart play. Really good heading play. Especially it worked out beautifully for them because they got the guy that's on the line who's 6-for-6 right now on the free throw line with 15 points. They're 13-for-16 on the free throw line. You wonder where I get all those numbers? Marty Arnoff makes me look good. And that's hard, Mike. Anybody making me look good?
80-69. 2:59 to go.
Lead the conference in free throw shooting. Oh, he finally missed one. He finally missed one. What happened to him?
That's why he's 86% instead of a.
Miller. That could have went the other way. Gary might have got one there.
I thought he'd easily gone the other way.
I thought he beat him to the spot, Mike. I got one eye, so it's tough for me. You got two eyes. What do you think? I think he's there.
Well, he looked like it.
It is close. Oh, tough to make that call. The Zebras do such a good job, I believe. I swear to God. You can sit here if you want to be so critical and take them apart. These guys do all they can out there to make the right. It's not an easy game, as we know.
Oh, this is an excellent crew. One shot. One excellent crew after another here. Blake is a brilliant free throw shooter as Mouton comes back in, but he doesn't have enough attempts to qualify for the league leadership. He would be third at 87%.
Coming back next year with a great recruiting class at Maryland, a new building, no longer the cold field house, coming to an end after all those great memories.
Now it's a 9-point lead. And Juan Dixon commits the personal.
It's going to get down to free throw shooting time. If they convert on a free throw line, they win. If they don't, they'll make it interesting down the stretch.
This is the first of two semifinals. Wake Forest and Duke coming up next on ESPN for the right to go to the championship game. And I would expect something like this in that one, a very close, hotly contested ballgame. Melvin goes to the line for the first time today. He already has 18 points.
Hey, Brad, do you think, I'm just wondering, Brad, what do you think? Do you think there's a possibility that a lot of Dukies are right now cheering for NC State?
Absolutely. It's Maryland basketball team, such a big ball club. Anytime you have to play against them, I mean, it's really hard to match up. Duke had a difficult time matching up with them as well as Wake. So I think that they're cheering for North Carolina State. No doubt. The way State's playing, I don't know if I would want to face these guys either.
77% shooter, just missed two. Maryland still with an opportunity. Holton, good save.
That could be big, those two free throws that were missed. He's got to take it up strong.
Lonnie Baxter, it's down to seven.
That's a four-point turnaround. It would have been an 11-point lead instead of seven. That was a big miss on a line by Melvin. Those two free throws. Uh-oh.
Crawford lost the break ahead. Nicholas is fine.
Here they are. They're back again.
This and Herb Sendek has to get a timeout.
This baby's not over, Mike. We said how important the free throw line would be. And Melvin missed those two. They went big. The Turk fans get alive.
6 points in 33 seconds for Maryland to cut it to five.
They're not going away, man. You're not 26-3 when the ACC by 2 games are going to fold. Where is he going with the ball? Out of control. Out of control.
Crawford trying to get through the double team.
And as Blake off the steal, find the open man. Gary Williams says, get into it, boy. Yes. Yes.
You know, his team may be looking ahead, but he's not.
You got that right. I don't think I've ever met a coach looking ahead. Coaches constantly only think of one thing. The most current game. Look at the turnover, 17-11. Herb Sendek's kids have played so brilliantly. It would be Heartbreak Hotel if they let this slip away.
A 9-1 run for the Terps. And again, full court pressure.
Who's Hodge perfectly. Great size, put up high to him. They got a Grundy and Mr. Miller to handle the ball as much as possible down the stretch. Coming to the last 2 minutes.
Ekdemoff out here as well, and Baxter going for the steal, commits the personal. That'll send Ekdemoff to the line. He's a 72% shooter. That's four on Lonnie Baxter.
You know, people hear us talk about free throw shooting, how important it is. I mean, think about Melvin in that sequence. He makes those two. They're up 11. Instead, he misses. Mike, it's down to seven.
Ekdemoff, big tries here. Hits the first.
And that's been
cold-blooded stroke there.
That's been their strong suit, making free throws.
Wilcox will come back in, and Holden will go out. 12 points for Ekdemoff. He's hit all three from the line.
Shot brilliantly last night from the three-point line.
Only one of two.
So they go 1-for-4 on the line here down the stretch.
Giving the Terps an opportunity. They're down by only six with still 2 minutes to go.
They're trying to look for Nicholas or Dixon.
Blake. Oh, that's a tough shot. And foul by Miller.
Silly foul. It's three. It's going to be three attempts. It's three, Mike.
Archie Miller cannot commit that foul.
Not an experienced player. He shot that in a hurried fashion. Chances of that going in are slim and maybe none.
He had Blake exactly where he wanted him.
Yeah, chance of this going down is slim and none. I mean, really, he's taking up the shot with pressure on him, and then he reaches in and grabs the forearm.
Got him on the forearm. 16 points, 17 now for Blake. He's got a double-double with 11 assists, and he's hit 3 out of 4 free throws. And guess what? It's back to 5. It could be 4.
And also, you stop the clock right now. That allows you to rotate into your defense after he converts.
Blake can now make it 3.
That was a nightmarish mistake right there by the little guy.
Archie Miller's never going to block that shot anyway.
He's got to know better. He's a senior, experienced player. Comes from a great basketball family. There's nobody that feels worse than he does, trust me.
Blake, 3-for-3, 81-78. Oh, Dixon got close to that one. Hodge
got real close. Look at Dixon picking up that defense. The intensity, the emotion, the passion.
Melvin beats the 10-second count.
They want that final, baby. They want the trifecta this year, the regular season, the tournament, and the NCAA.
They'd sure like to get a good shot on this possession.
I'd say Mr. Grundy. They're taking the clock right down.
I wouldn't want it in anybody's hands but his. They give it up to Ekdemoff. There's only 3 on the shot clock.
Oh, they don't know.
And Hodge. Oh! Holy cow!
Oh!
what's happened.
That's impossible.
Oh, of all guys, the worst perimeter shooter.
He just threw it as the shot clock expired, and it was nothing but net. Blake all the way under to Baxter.
I tell you, I like the fight of the Maryland kids, not quitting, just fighting and scrapping, reflecting their coach.
But how did Hodge do that?
Mr. Hodge, look at him smiling. Look at him smiling.
He ought to be smiling.
He said, I did it on the playgrounds, man, on the asphalt in New York City. The clock is winding down. He said, I'm going to let the rock go. And there it goes. He said, who said I don't have a stroke?
Dick, they did a terrible job on that possession working the shot clock.
Unbelievable. Look at the tongue. Look at the tongue. Michael! Michael! I didn't know Michael's in the house.
What a shot. 84-80 with under a minute to go. Three-point shooting, 13 yesterday, which was a school record in the ACC tournament. They're gaining on it today, although not shooting nearly as well from a percentage standpoint.
Maybe not over right now. They say go pack, but these are going to be a long 58.5 seconds for Herb Sundin.
Carl Ravage and Digger Phelps standing by for our College Basketball Championship Week update presented by 7-Up. Kansas, we saw that earlier on a roll, Conference USA final, and more automatic bids being dealt out today.
How good are they, Kansas? But you know, Mike, Herb Sendick, remember several years ago, he took NC State to the final, shocked people playing five guys, but they were in more of a delay game. This is a different kind of team.
And he had to do it through the play-in game as well.
Exactly.
The lead is four with 58 and a half seconds to go.
38 years of age, has had so much pressure on him this year to survive. All the talk shows were asking for his job last year. Here comes the full court matchup.
Maryland's going to have to foul if they can't get the steal.
Oh, look at him. Grundy as a relay man. Nice job of coaching.
Grundy cut off, gets it back to Miller. They beat the 10-second count.
Diagonal pass.
Now they foul Melvin, who missed his last two.
And he's got to be thinking. He's got to be thinking. He has Morby in an excellent stroke, as we see from the perimeter. Herb Sendick talking to Larry Hunter, a lot of experience. Larry Harris on the staff does a heck of a job.
State has missed four of its last five free throws. Melvin missed his last two.
And he's a good free throw shooter, Mike. And he is a good free throw shooter. You look at his numbers for the year, 78%.
A lot of pressure.
He's thinking too much. You got to go up there, your rhythm, and shoot it. He's thinking too much, man. He's thinking too much.
That 15-footer must look like a half a mile right now.
Well, he's a 78% shooter, but he doesn't look like one. His body language, very bad. Now, look at this here. He's thinking. He's feeling frustrated. Well, he knows. He sees, darn it.
He just can't believe it. It's like a 15-foot putt. Got one out of four. It's a two-possession game.
Right now, you don't need the quick three. You take the first deuce you can get, or if it's a shot in your offense for three, that's something else.
Grundy is on Dixon. They'd love to get the ball. Oh, Dixon, what a shot by Blake.
Great drive by Blake. Maryland team just doesn't go away. So tenacious.
Grundy, brilliant job. Drives the court.
Oh! Threw it away! That caught up in the air.
Maryland can tie with a three. Holy cow, what a finish.
Got Miller and Dixon.
Nicholas with a long three. Juan Dixon.
What a rebound by Dixon against Miller. Had the size.
Miller got a break. He really ran him out of there. Baxter lost the ball. Now Grundy has it. And a foul on Lonnie Baxter with 9.7 seconds to go.
What a great game. What an unbelievable moment. The ACC.
Holy cow.
I'm worn out sitting here, Mike. Imagine how these kids feel, pouring their hearts out, playing with so much passion, so much energy. Look at this. Look at Dixon. Watch Dixon with the great size. Coming over the back of Miller. Now he's going to try to make a pass, and the ball's going to go to the deck. Let's see the hustle here. Oh, I don't know. They call a foul on Baxter. Look at Grundy scrapping and clawing. All ACC. Stop want the run. Look at him diving for the fumble. Like the loose ball. Those long arms made that happen.
Baxter has fouled out of the ball game. 15.7 rebounds. And Anthony Grundy can smell the victory.
Playing his heart out. Got to convert here. This baby's not over.
No, but you get the feeling you make one of two, and it is.
Yeah, if you make one out of two. You got to make one, though, Mike, to make it a two-possession game. I've seen so many crazy miracles over the years. In fact, the ACC's had their version, Dean Smith, over the years.
Grundy has hit all three of his free throws today. As a team, they missed 5 of 7.
Well, he's the guy you want in the line other than Miller. Because, and he
missed the first.
The reason I said you want him on the line, because he's the veteran. He's the experienced player. He's the guy that's, hey, I'm going to take you to the winner's locker room, man. Because he's been carrying them all year, this kid.
All the pressure in the world on the shoulders of the senior.
Missed them both.
He was tight on him, too.
Juan Dixon, a three. Good tie. Uh-oh. There's the double team. Fires. He missed it. And it's out of bounds to NC State.
Maryland gutting it back, trying to get a situation, forcing it to overtime, but NC State comes up with the missed jumper.
Juan Dixon brought it down, running out of time, put up the shot, and it came up short. So their best 2 3-point shooters in the last two possessions, Nicholas and Dixon, missed shots in a 20-second span that would have tied it.
They got the guy that wanted to shoot it. Normally a clutch pressure guy. Little too deep. Little too deep. And to see Dixon right here. That's a long range jumper, man. That is from Greensboro. Hits the side, clanks off.
Boy, North Carolina State, the best free throw shooting team in the conference at better than 75%. Has missed 7 of its last 9 and given Maryland 2 chances. I think the Terps are out of chances, barring a miraculous steal here.
We said at the 3-minute mark that it will come down to free throw shooting. You convert, you lock it up. They didn't convert, and they made it a war for themselves.
Grundy has it, fouled by Nicholas. Boy, oh boy, what a ball game.
That's been a tremendous game. What an effort by the NC State kids.
Wake back in the tunnel.
They're hungry, man. They want the Dukies today. They are hungry. Muggsy Bogues told me that today at the brunch I spoke at, and he was on it. He said, my Deacons are going to be ready, baby.
They were hungry. They should have gone to the brunch.
Oh, it was great. The food was great.
Grundy can wrap it up. He has 23 points. He's Are you kidding?
He's not getting that rotation. I mean, we're not looking at a kid that shoots 40%.
Maryland somehow still alive.
Yeah, they are.
The Packs missed 8 of its last 10.
He's got to convert this one. Remember, the clock doesn't start until someone touches the ball on the floor.
That's Grundy, it's a 4-point lead.
Upset City, baby. It'll be no Duke in Maryland. It'll be NC State, a courageous group.
Getting them off with a steal, and it's over. The Wolfpack of North Carolina State has knocked off number 2 Maryland. They will go into the championship game tomorrow. What a brilliant effort by the Wolfpack.
Celebration led by Mr. Grundy, the catalyst, the driver, the slasher, but it was a team effort by Herb Sendick. Coaches did a great job putting a game plan together, and they executed. Look at the celebration. Look at the joy, the pain they went through last year, the disappointment last year. Freshman hugging his seniors. Look at the love, man. Give me some love. Give me some love.
There is no feeling like winning.
Oh, you got that right, Mike.
Grundy with 24. Led 5 players in double figures. North Carolina State shoots 59% from the floor. They earned this one today. They earned it big time.
No doubt.
Not too much time to celebrate, though. They have to get ready for the championship game tomorrow. They'll rest a little bit and watch Wake Forest and Duke play for the other berth in about a half an hour from now. Unbelievable. Let's go to Brad Daugherty. He's got Marcus Melvin.
Thanks, Mike. I'm here with Marcus Melvin. Marcus, you guys, you came out today. You took it to them early. You knocked them back on their heels, and you stuck with your game plan. Tell us a little bit about that game plan early.
My game plan was to come here and try to keep them off the boards and try to guard their flex offense because, you know, everybody knows that is a real something key when you come in to play Maryland. We wanted to keep them off the glass, wanted to get offensive rebounds and things like that, and also run our offense to perfection, and we did that. We won the game.
You did a great job. Very big basketball team, Maryland. You came out early, set the tone, though, hitting the three-pointers, drawing the defenders out. You were knocking down the threes today.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to try to do today. Because Coach said that, you know, they had four men who couldn't guard the perimeter and things like that. So I wanted to use that to my advantage.
Marcus, great game. Congratulations. Good luck tomorrow. That's Marcus Melvin, North Carolina State.
Brad, thank you very much. Just an absolutely brilliant performance by the Wolfpack as they win their 22nd game of the year. Maryland loses only its fourth. Duke and Wake, our second semifinal game. And the party that everybody anticipated for tomorrow is not going to happen. It's not going to be Duke and Maryland. It's going to be NC State and one of these teams. That's the story from Charlotte. Great first semifinal. Let's go to Carl and Digger.
Hi, Mike and Dick. Thank you very much. Game two just about 20 minutes from now. NC State is young, but boy, they play with a lot of poise. And this is something that you recognized about this team, perhaps their potential way back, what, in February?
No, let's go back to December 8th when NC State played at Syracuse and won that game. Anthony Grundy got it going. And this is a Syracuse team at that time that just had won the preseason NIT, beating Michigan State in New York, as well as Wake Forest. You've got to say, where does the birth of this team start? That, to me, was the maturity of Grundy taking his team over. And you love Archie Miller's leadership. And those two players, to me, are the reason why you saw this unfold today.
A little perspective. It appears as if Duke wins, they will get the number one seed in the East. This means Maryland will get the number one seed in the South. In the semifinals, the South will play the West, which means they'll likely avoid Kansas. And that's probably more important, perhaps, to Gary, 48 hours from now than it would be.